Hi, hello and welcome. Microbehunter here, and today we're gonna look at the cell organelles of this onion here. I'll have to first dissect it and then I'll put it under the microscope. Well, there is absolutely no need to chop apart the whole onion. So what I'm doing is I'm simply cutting out a little square, just the right size to be placed under the microscope. So a parallel cut, you turn the onion 90 degrees, another parallel cut, and I'll be able to get some of the onion layers out. They drop out quite easily. And what I'm interested in is in observing the so-called the onion skin. And this can be taken off quite easily with your fingers. So you see it peels off. And this layer is only one cell layer thick. And that means it's perfect to be placed under the microscope. So I'm just gonna do another one here. You can see that this onion skin here, the inside skin here, peels off quite easily. And this is then gonna be put on a microscope slide. Well, here is the slide. First, a small drop of water. That is pretty much all you need, because you want to directly place the onion skin into this water. Sticks a little bit, so you can see I have some problems getting it off my tweezers. I place a drop of water on the top. It doesn't want to stay there really, because the top part seems to be a little bit hydrophobic. In any case, a cover glass does go on top, and all of the excess water I'm going to remove now, because I do not want that my microscope becomes flooded when the water spills over the edge of the microscope slide. So a little bit of tissue paper will do the trick here. You can see that their onion skin is now compressed and flat on the microscope slide, and we're ready to roll. It goes under the microscope, and let's have a look at some of these cells here. And what you can see is that the cells, they look like bricks in a wall. So all of those little horizontal structures, these are all the individual cells. And what you see here, that is, these are the cell walls. The cell walls are quite thick. But the inside of the cell, you don't seem to see a lot at this magnification. I'm using my 4x magnifying objective. But look at the cell in the center, right? The cell in the center. I'm going to now go a little bit higher. We're using the 10x objective, and we can see that the central cell has a circle at the top, and this circle, that is the nucleus which stores the DNA. Yet at a higher magnification, the circle now of course also becomes bigger. It's pretty much in the center, and now we can already see a little bit of movement. Maybe you can see that there are small dots streaming inside the cell now. Yet at a higher magnification, those dots, they have a directional movement. They're not just wiggling around, but they're actually streaming, and they seem to be vesicles, time lapse. And here we can see it quite well. Okay, that's a time lapse image. You can see that these small cell organelles, they seem to be vesicles carrying substances around. They basically move around in a cell. This is now 20 times the original speed, and you can see that there are almost like little highways inside a cell along which these cell organelles seem to move. And as a matter of fact, these vesicles, what they are being done is they're being pulled along a protein network inside the cell called the cytoskeleton. These are small, microscopically not even visible because they're so small, protein fibers. And what they do is they pull along these vesicles. Yet at a higher magnification, you can see that there's quite a little bit of activity going on around the nucleus here. You can actually really see that there are certain paths along which the cells, not the cells, the vesicles move. So again, time lapse, 20 times the original speed. And some people can also, yeah, we call this also cytoplasmic streaming. And some people also like to observe this in water plants called Elodea. I actually did make another video of this. And in Elodea, you can actually see the movement of the chloroplasts. And that's also quite nice and interesting to see. Yeah, so that is basically when we eat an onion, You never forget that, or any cell for that matter, any fruit, any vegetable, never forget there is still quite a little bit of movement going on in your mouth when you chew it. This is now my mobile phone, and now I held it in front of a low-cost educational microscope. Can we see it also with a low-cost microscope like this? Or do we need a fancy, expensive microscope? And sure enough, here we go. Look, even here, such a microscope also allows me to see, or allows you to see, the movement of these cell organelles. So you do not need any fancy equipment. By the way, an affiliate link to this microscope is in the description, and it actually shows that you do not need anything expensive to see important biological activity in cells. It also works quite fine with this educational microscope. Yeah, so you can also see that there are these little dots, the vesicles moving around. In any case, let's enjoy the movement of cell organelles a little bit for a couple of more seconds. I wish you, in any case, all the best. Happy microbe hunting, happy cell organelle hunting, I should rather say. See you next time. Please also like and subscribe the video. All the best. Bye bye.